Hello, and welcome to the Radeon Memory Visualizer 1.1 update. This presentation focuses on the new features and support recently added to the Radeon Memory Visualizer, which is also known as RMV. Version 1.1 adds underlying support for the RDNA2 hardware features as supported in the AMD Radeon RX 6000 series GPUs. Significant improvements have been made to the visualization of aliased resources. There are new controls in the Allocation Overview and the Allocation Explorer, and the Allocation Viewer now displays the resource aliases associated with a memory allocation. Lastly, one small but useful improvement is the ability to link resources in the Memory Leak Finder back to the other RMV UIs. Let's take a look at these changes in more detail. As a quick reminder, RMV is a tool that is used to visualize the GPU memory usage of graphics applications. The memory usage data is provided by the developer driver and is produced by using the Radeon Developer Panel, which is shown here. If you want more information on how to use the latest developer panel, you can find a video update about Radeon Developer 2.2 on GPU Open. Shown here is an RMV GPU memory trace file that has been generated using the developer panel. The memory trace is 50 seconds in length, and I've created three snapshots at points of interest in the timeline. A snapshot is a detailed description of the GPU memory usage at a specific point in time, and can be opened for viewing by double-clicking in the list below the graph. When a snapshot is opened, the heap overview is displayed with summaries for each heap and the various resource types. Look for any warnings displayed in this view, as these may point to some obvious performance issues that you may have overlooked. To see the resource aliasing changes introduced in RMV 1.1, I'm going to switch to the resource overview using the button on the left-hand side. In RMV's resource overview, aliased resources are rendered using a stippled background. Zooming in, we can see this a little bit more clearly. Another way to explicitly view aliased resources is to use RMV's Color By feature to color them separately. We can use the pull-down menu to select Color By aliasing. In this mode, the aliased resources can easily be identified in red, and all other resources in grey. Clicking on a specific resource highlights it in the Resource Details pane at the bottom of the view, indicating its size, offset, and usage type. Switching to the Allocation Overview, we can see the allocations ordered by size and any placed resources within the allocation. At the top of the view, we can select the Normalize Allocations toggle to fill the width and see the placed resources more clearly. Aliased resources are also rendered in this view using the stippled pattern. To visualize the actual aliased resources, select the Show Aliasing toggle at the top of the view. Each allocation is now replaced by rows of resource aliases that reference the same memory. Still, it's a little unclear, so to help, we can adjust the allocation height slider at the top to increase the height of the bars. Each horizontal bar represents an aliased resource and can be selected individually. We can double-click on a resource to jump to the Allocation Explorer, where we can focus on just the parent allocation and see a lot more information for each of the resources. In this view, the allocation has been selected from the list of all the allocations in the top of the view. We can see the placed resources within the allocation central bar, and the currently selected resources highlighted in the resource list at the bottom of the view. By selecting the Show Aliasing toggle, we can reveal the aliased resources. And by selecting the splitter bar, we can increase the height of the allocation bar. Each of the aliased resources is now visible and has been color-coded by type. On selection, each resource will be highlighted in the resource list below. The details of an individual resource can be viewed by double-clicking on the resource in the resource list. This will open the resource in the Resource Details view, where we can see a summary of the main details, its properties, physical residency, and its lifecycle events up until the point of the snapshot. We hope you find RMV's new aliased memory visualizations useful when optimizing your applications to use overlap GPU resources. Next, I want to talk about the small improvement that we've made to the snapshot comparison view. If you remember, snapshot comparison is a useful tool for investigating logical memory leaks, such as forgetting to unload resources on a level change. In this example, I'm using three snapshots, before, during, and after a change in the game. By selecting two of the snapshots, right-clicking and selecting the Compare Snapshot pop-up, we can generate the memory delta between the two. Here we can see the Memory Leak Finder UI. In RMV 1.1, you can now double-click on a resource to open it in the Resource Details view. Here you can expect its timeline events to see what time it was allocated and bound, and this can give insights into its origin and its relevance at the time of the snapshot. While in the Resource Details view, I should point out that RMV 1.1 has added unmapped memory category to the physical residency pie graph. That wraps it up for the Radeon Memory Visualizer update. Here's a quick review of the new features introduced in version 1.1. The Radeon Memory Visualizer is now part of the Radeon Developer Tools suite and can be downloaded directly from GPU Open at the address shown on screen. Thanks for watching, and you can check out more on GPU Open. Bye.